There are many things we don't know about the universe, but there is one thing that is particularly bizarre. Why is gravity so much weaker than the other known forces? Now, it might not seem obvious that gravity is incredibly, ridiculously weak, but I can illustrate the fact with a simple magnet and paperclip. If I put the paperclip on the magnet, a jaw-dropping thing happens. The paperclip sticks to the magnet. Now, I know what you're saying. You're saying, well, yeah. But it might be that you've not thought through exactly what that means. This paperclip is feeling two forces, the force due to the magnet pulling it up and the gravity of the Earth pulling it down. I'll say that again a bit slower. A tiny little magnet is pulling the paperclip upwards, and the gravity of an entire planet is pulling the paperclip downwards, and the magnet wins. If you think about it a bit, this means that gravity is really an incredibly weak force. So why is it that gravity is so much weaker than the force of magnetism? Well, the simple fact is nobody knows. The answer to that question is one of the biggest mysteries of modern physics, and the reward for figuring that out is one of these babies here. It would look awfully good on a shelf in my den, don't you think? Well, nobody knows the answer. There are some ideas that scientists are kicking around. And one of the coolest ideas is the idea that gravity might inhabit extra dimensions, more dimensions than the three with which we are familiar. The problem is that the idea of dimensions has been used frequently in science fiction to mean many things. For example, an alternate universe. I mean, you don't have to be much of a science fiction buff to have encountered a movie in which history was different. For instance, a history in which the British won the war for American independence. Even if you don't watch many movies, I can help you understand the idea a bit better with the help of some of my physicist colleagues. For example, we all know that physicists are simply the hippest kind of scientist on the planet, as you can see from my two colleagues here, Brian and Jason.
So,
in the alternate reality idea, it could be that there are universes in which physicists aren't hip. For instance, there could be a parallel dimension in which Brian is a total geek. Or even an alternate reality in which the super hip Jason is actually a giant talking rabbit called Mr. Snuffles. What do you guys think? Does this seem weird to you, Brian?
Why, not at all. This is indubitably the very paradigm of normality.
And Mr. Snuffles?
Actually, this is pretty comfortable, and I don't have to wear any pants.
You know, I find this all pretty disconcerting. Let's change back to our own reality. I mean, the idea of parallel dimensions is kind of interesting, but I'm pretty sure that physicists are the very definition of hip in all universes. Thanks for helping out, guys.
You got it.
These concepts of alternate realities are not what physicists mean when they talk about extra dimensions. Instead, what we mean are literal extra dimensions of space. Just as we know of the familiar three dimensions of left, right, up, down, and forward and backward, we are postulating one or more additional dimensions. Now, the idea of additional dimensions just seems totally ludicrous. I mean, here I am, existing in a three-dimensional world. I mean, it's completely understandable if you think the whole idea is, well, completely. But what if, and bear with me here, just what if the fact that gravity is so much weaker than magnetism can be explained by the idea that gravity exists in more dimensions than magnetism? How would that work? We can understand the concept by using the example of billiards as an analogy. So you know the basic idea. If you play properly, the billiard balls are constrained to move in two dimensions, specifically around the surface of the table. A ball can move across the table, or it can move along the table, but it doesn't leave the surface. However, the sound of the impact of collision of two balls can radiate in three dimensions. You can hear the sound above the surface of the table. While the balls move in two, sound moves in three dimensions. So suppose that gravity is similar. Electromagnetism and the strong and weak nuclear forces that hold matter together might move in three dimensions. But maybe gravity can move in four, or maybe even more. Under this idea, if gravity can spread into more dimensions, maybe gravity is really strong. It's just that some of its strength moves into the other extra dimensions. Now, there is a reason why this idea sounds pretty silly. We actually know the number of dimensions gravity spreads into in our common experience. The way we know this is actually pretty compelling, and it's easy to understand. In 1687, Sir Isaac Newton published his law of gravity, and what it said, that is, if you take a small object, the gravitational field it exerts gets weaker in a manner that is proportional to 1 over the square of the distance from the object. Why the world should be this way is simple. The gravitational field from the object spreads out equally in all directions, and it passes through the surface of a sphere surrounding the object. We know that the surface of a sphere is 4 times pi times the radius of the surface squared. The square of the radius from the area of a sphere and Newton's radius squared is the same. Since a sphere is a three-dimensional object, this pretty much proves that gravity goes into three dimensions. However, there is a catch. Scientists have tested Newton's law of gravity over huge size scales, from the size of a solar system, or even bigger, down to the sizes that are a 20th of a millimeter or so. However, people haven't directly tested how gravity works for even smaller sizes. What if there were additional small dimensions? Can that idea save us? Well, the answer is maybe. And given the importance of the question, scientists have come up with some ideas about how that might work. If there are smaller dimensions, then they can't be like our familiar ones. The familiar ones are infinitely big, and even if the new ones were smaller, a smaller infinity is still infinity. But what if the smaller dimensions were different? Maybe at every point in ordinary space, there are small additional dimensions that wrapped back in on themselves. Now, this idea sounds, well, pretty crazy, but let's use another analogy to get the basic idea. I am talking about, of course, tightrope walking. A tightrope walker, well, a successful one anyway, can move only in one dimension, forward and back. However, an ant on the same rope can not only move forward and backward, it can move around the rope itself. The second dimension is around the circumference of the rope, and it is much smaller than the long dimensions to which the tightrope walker has access. Similarly, perhaps there are other smaller dimensions that gravity can enter. So that's where measurements at particle accelerators come in. If one simply makes the assumption that extra small dimensions of space is the reason that gravity is so weak, it is straightforward to work out the consequences of that idea. Then scientists can look at their data to see if those behaviors are observed. If they are, we can begin to be confident that the idea of extra dimensions could be right. So far, there is no indication in the data that this idea is the explanation for the weakness of gravity. But that doesn't discourage scientists. With the resumption of operations of the Large Hadron Collider in 2015, physicists can study even smaller dimensions than before. It could be that the LHC could have a huge new message to teach us. And I'll let you know if I hear anything exciting.